name is Christy Setlock, and I'm on Devin and Dion's horror show. Yeah, D&D.
Okay, we got Christy Setlock on the show. You see her here? Yeah, one of the greatest right now. We're going to get up into the show. All right. Okay, tonight's questions, and, you know, vibe, it's a fun vibe. Christy Setlock, new to the show.
And that's why I got to wear this cool
sunglasses. Yeah, she got to wear the cool sunglasses like I do Sashi. And,
I'm sorry, Devin. You know. I'll give these back after the show, though. They're mine for now.
Yeah. All right.
I appreciate you having me on.
I appreciate you too, Christy. And I'm going to go into it. All right. First off, where are you from? And what made you get into acting? We want to know.
Okay. Well, I'm a Georgia girl, born and raised. Okay. So, ATL, shout it, you know, all that good stuff. And, yeah, I've never really lived anywhere else, but I've always wanted to be in acting ever since I was little.
Okay.
My mom will tell you a bunch of embarrassing stories of me just walking up to strangers doing monologues.
Did you used to act characters out like one of the favorite movies
you've
seen?
Oh, of course. Oh, my gosh. You want to talk about my big frat Greek wedding? I can do it. I had a lump in the back of my neck. And I used to go up to strangers doing this. It was crazy.
What did they think about it?
I'm sure they were terrified. I mean, I was like a five-year-old coming up to them. But, you know, it was my passion, and my parents were excited about that. So, and my mom was actually really interested in, like, acting as well, but more on the producing and, like, casting side.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you know about, like, Houghton Talent? It's like one of the biggest talent agencies in Atlanta.
No,
okay, well, it's one of the casting agencies in Atlanta. And they're one of the best.
Mm-hmm.
And it used to be, my mom helped start it.
Okay.
So it was going to be called Houghton and Setlock Casting.
Oh, that's cool.
But my mom wanted to have children, like an idiot. No, but, and so she bailed out. And now Houghton is this huge casting agency, and then little did she know, her child, which she bowed out for to have, now wants to be in entertainment. And I'm like, Mom, what the heck is going on? Like, come on, you should have stayed with it. But, so clearly it's in my blood, and
so
I don't
she's
know.
Happy with what you're doing now? I mean,
I wouldn't say that, but, you know, it's a tough industry, so I don't think that any parents really are super excited about it, but you know, she's supportive, so the fact that I'm going into horror and stuff, she likes that a lot.
Yeah.
She's a big horror queen as well, so I don't know, we'll see where my career goes.
Well,
and hopefully she'll be proud.
Well, since you was growing up with that, with these movies, I'm gonna ask you, who are your favorite actors and actress that's out there right now to this day, from the 90s, if you remember, up until present?
Okay, are you talking horror only? Are you talking in general?
In general.
Ooh, okay, that's tough. I love Tom Hanks.
Okay.
Probably because he reminds me of my dad. I'm a big daddy's girl.
Okay.
Shout out, Dad.
Okay.
But I also think he has a wide range, but Toni Collette is definitely, especially in the horror genre, like, she's just incredible to me.
Who did you say?
Toni Collette.
Have you ever seen
Hereditary?
No, I haven't seen it.
You haven't?
Nope.
And you call yourself a horror man? Oh,
I go 80s and horror.
Okay, we're watching Hereditary after this. It has to be on your list.
Okay.
Like, it is hands down.
When it came out?
Oh my god, like 3 years ago, maybe?
Years ago, okay.
I don't know. Don't quote me on that. I'm not sure. Pretty recently.
Okay.
But it is one of the most, like, terrifying, but not in a cliche way.
Okay.
Like, it's very more psychological thriller.
Okay. Like, psycho.
And it's, yeah, kind of, but it's like, it really dives deep. Trust me, I'm gonna make you watch it.
Misery.
It's that kind of vibe.
Okay.
Have you
what's
okay,
her name?
Toni Collette is the mom.
Oh, that's her.
That's Toni Collette.
Yes, I see her.
There we go.
Yeah, I see her in the movie. Yeah, she's good.
She's great.
Yeah, she's good.
So, she's definitely on my list for sure. And then I'm, just from my childhood, I've always been a Shia LaBeouf fan. Because
Shia LaBeouf, okay.
He was
even
like,
Stevens.
Well, he was my first Shia crush. Yeah. Which,
okay.
That's when I knew I was, like, semi-straight.
Okay.
Well. So, all that good stuff. All
right. Okay, Christy, what made you get into modeling and comedy?
Oh, okay. Well, modeling, I guess, kind of came as a, high school kind of thing. Yeah,
A dream, the moment comes.
It wasn't even really a dream. It was more of just something that would make money,
Okay.
And, when you're in high school, you're looking your best,
All the guys love you, like you're good shape for it.
Well, thank you. it wasn't ever, my favorite thing to do.
Okay.
Because, it's so superficial. And not that there's anything wrong with that.
Okay.
A lot of people are successful in it, and there's absolutely no reason why you shouldn't
do it.
There's
a lot of runways and all that stuff. There's a lot of crazy stuff right now, too.
Yeah.
Modeling.
It's just, I guess, when I was, I modeled for Monster for a little bit.
Who?
And Monster, like the energy drink.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And I remember I went to a shoot, and they gave us all, our outfits.
Okay.
And we were all lined up, and they were giving out the outfits.
Hats and t-shirt, the match.
The skimpy stuff.
Oh, yeah, them. Okay.
And, which is fine, but the girl in front of me asked, where's the changing room?
Mm-hmm.
And they literally, sorry about that. Mm-hmm. I got a little wine in my system, but,
That's okay.
this is a fun talk show, right?
Yeah. Rolling.
So I was in line, and, to get our outfits and stuff, and the girl right in front of me asked where the changing room was, and the guy running the event just fired her on the spot.
Wow.
And he was like, I don't even have time to show you or do any of that, so get out of here. And so I looked around, and all the other girls were just changing their clothes in public.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, and I just dropped my stuff and left because I was like, maybe this isn't what I wanted to do.
You shouldn't have did that. You shouldn't have did that at all. You shouldn't have stayed. Maybe just didn't like her.
I'm not going to change my clothes and, just openly. No, it's not. I don't know. It's just right then and there I knew that maybe modeling wasn't my calling.
Yeah.
And
but that was the type of modeling that you was doing. If you're a special model, you
that's
to,
true. That's very true. And I have done some modeling after that, but maybe not to that degree.
Okay.
But that's when I really transitioned into comedy because there.
Okay. Yeah, it's gonna be your comedy.
Yeah.
What's going on with this comedy?
See
you on this stage and stuff like that. I forgot the name of the place that you went to. What's the name of that?
The last
skull,
one.
Skull.
The Laughing Skull.
Laughing Skull. Okay.
Yeah, that was the last one I was at. And
how many times you been there though?
I guess. Six, seven times. But before then, I was working a lot at the Punchline Comedy Club.
Mm-hmm.
The original Punchline. The OG Punchline. Because it's very famous around Atlanta. It's where a bunch of comics got started.
Okay.
And, but it got torn down recently, so they had to move it over. And at that point, I was like, well, I don't really want
to. You get into Tyler Perry?
I've worked with Tyler Perry.
Oh, what you do with Tyler Perry?
Well,
let's see what she did with Tyler Perry, guys.
Oh my gosh. Okay, no. Don't get too excited. Don't get too
okay. Are you a people person?
I would like to believe so, yeah.
Okay. All right. Who's the sexiest man on earth?
Sexiest?
The sexiest man on earth. We all want to hear.
Michael B. Jordan.
Everybody
knows. Come on.
The Idris Elba. That's what I thought.
Oh my God, he's a close second.
Okay.
Oh yeah. Okay. I can't. Nobody can look at Michael B. Jordan and think.
Come on. I know I can't.
Think anything other than what I'm thinking.
Okay.
Ladies, you know what I'm talking about.
Of course they do. But do you like Britney Spears and Lady Gaga?
Oh.
Because she's kind of weird, so that's why I kind of add her to the horror show. They kind of do weird things in their videos.
I don't think Britney Spears does as much weird
she
stuff.
She did in two videos I've seen. But Lady Gaga, she's definitely...
Oh, my car is literally called Gaga.
Alejandro. That one.
Yeah.
And what's the name of that song? Paparazzi. That was kind of weird too.
Well, when she first came out, I feel like she was a lot weirder than she is now. But I kind of think that's why I like her so much, because she used her weirdness to break out into and let other people kind of recognize that weirdness is cool.
Yeah.
And now she went over the top with it at first, but now she's been able to kind of settle into who she is and who she is as an artist. But I love that she used that weirdness to really pierce through that, like, you know, break the norm kind of thing. That's why I loved Britney Spears, of course, too. When I was younger, I think she was the first concert I ever went to, actually.
Britney Spears, man.
But Lady Gaga, like I said, my car is named Gaga, or Lady if she's acting right. But, you know, I really like how she used the weirdness to get in, to be able to be her true self. And I kind of feel like I relate to her in a lot of ways that way. Like, I am a super weird person, but...
You ain't that weird.
I mean...
So, what times you...
We'll
what,
see.
Okay, what sums it up with the types of music that you like?
Well, I'm not going to lie to you.
Okay.
I'm like a metalhead.
Metalhead?
I mean, I love rock music.
Rock
music. So much. I mean, I love all.
Name three rock bands that you just like.
Okay.
I gotta go see them.
Well, okay. Let me ask you.
Okay.
Are you asking for math rock? Are you asking for alternative rock? Are you
alternative? We're gonna start alternative.
Okay. Bliss.
Bliss. Okay. I mean,
you've never heard of them.
I heard their music and I seen their name.
Okay. Microwave.
Never heard of them.
Look them up. They're really good.
When they started? In the 80s, 90s,
2000s? No. They're like 2000s. Late
2000s.
Okay. Mariana Trench. They're more pop rock, but I'm a sucker for them because, you know, I listened to them when I was an emo little high school kid. Like,
you had a friend, you
nobody had understands me. I just really want, you know, Day to Remember. Bring Me a Horizon.
No, none.
Okay, we're gonna do homework after this.
No, I don't do no homework. I know what I need to do.
I'll send you a list. Don't worry.
Okay, I seen that you did cheerleading back at an early age, but you had problems with your knees, and I want to know what would that experience. What that experience was to you? How did you feel? Just tell me how you feel about that whole experience. You were chilling, you had your knees was like that. Like, how did it came about?
Like, during cheerleading or during filming?
Cheerleading. Because, I don't know. I mean, I do a lot of just research and I just, you know. Maybe I did it the wrong way. I don't know, but my bad. I just figured that, you know, when you were cheerleading, I probably misunderstood. When you were cheerleading.
No, dude. No, you didn't. You didn't. I understand where you're coming from.
Okay.
It
just touched my heart when I heard it. You know, because I did not know that. And, you know, when we was filming the film My House, I just figured, you know, I had this woman on the floor. And doing all this other stuff, you know, I should have not got sued, you know, something would have broke.
Yeah, it definitely was tough. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
I didn't let you know that at the time, but I'm a professional, you know.
Saying that.
So I have EDS, which is a syndrome in your knees.
Okay.
And I've had it since I was a child. I started in gymnastics, and they made me wear weights on my ankles. And
that was it. That's what I want to say. they made you wear wigs on your ankles. I'm like, wow.
Yeah.
It was interesting. And then it just touched me right there.
Well, it's, you know, as a child, your kneecaps aren't bone. They're cartilage.
Okay.
And as you get older, sorry, this is like scientific and probably not
interesting.
I'm cool with
it. But,
and as you get older, they become bone. So, if you mess with your wearing ankle weights, for example, when your kneecaps are still cartilage, that messes with your knees and creates a lot of problems. So,
your family would just, they accepted it, but, you know, you just, have you had any men that, like, you told them that story to? Any men you ever talked to besides the one you will? Have you told anybody that story? They just found out or whatever. You just really don't talk about it. You just really ain't important.
Well, no. Well, now that I'm an adult and now that it's become more apparent, I've talked to a lot of people about it.
Okay. The last question, this is a horror show. The last question is, what are your favorite horror movies?
Okay. I guess if you're talking the first horror movie I ever saw, let's go with The Ring.
The Ring. Okay.
Yeah, that was the first one. And then my favorite is probably Hereditary or Midsommar.
I never heard of it.
Really?
Midsommar. I ain't never heard of it.
Ari?
When did it come out?
Oh my gosh, like, I don't know, 2012?
See, that's why I don't know about it. I don't watch them type.
Okay, like I said, we are definitely going to have a...
Oh, I do 80s and 90s, early 2000s, I go back, bro.
No,
I won't do none of that new stuff.
We are definitely going to have a sit-down so I can teach you about these. Trust me, Ari Aster, he did Midsommar, Hereditary, none of...
I've probably seen it on here.
Oh,
is
my
gosh.
Is
it on Tubi or anything like that?
I believe so.
I hope it is. 2012. I'll probably check that out. But, okay. All right, this is the show. We're going to end it. Thanks for Christy Setlaw for being on the show. Christy, thanks for being on the show. And we out.
We out.